All right. So my name is Scott Gerbert, and I am the director of the Tobacco Use Prevention Education Program at the Alameda County Office of Education. And I am so excited to be, one, here tonight in this virtual setting, still holding this award ceremony for some amazing young people who have put together some fantastic posters, some audio clips, and some video clips. First, I want to also give a little shout out to the Alameda County Youth Advisory Board. Those are all the purple-shirted young people who are on the call right now. That's our County Youth Advisory Board, and they are the ones who came up with the theme for the event. They're the ones who came up with the video that welcomed an intro, the posters, and they're the ones who scored and evaluated the entry. So very excited that they're on the line, and there are 72 people in the room right now. But I want to welcome everybody. I know that we have some board members from some school districts that are on right now, and we have some staffers from various districts. I see Pleasanton, I see Livermore, I think I see some San Leandro folks, and I definitely see a couple of people from Alameda County Office of Education, so welcome. And I really want to make sure I recognize there's a couple of board members that I saw that came in as well from Alameda County Office of Ed. And I want to let you know there's a couple of parts to this evening. The first part, we're going to have a message that L. Karen Monroe, the superintendent for the County Office of Education in Alameda, she was not able to be here tonight, so she has a pre-recorded message for all of us, welcoming everybody and congratulating everybody. Normally, we'd be doing this at the County Office of Education in Hayward, and she would proudly be standing up in front of all of you, congratulating your young people. And then we'll roll from her message, we'll roll into our MCs for tonight, which are Meadow and Sahar, who are with the County Youth Advisory Board. And then everybody will get to find out. If you were invited as one of the winners, just know you are a winner tonight. You're all winners for being here, but you are going to be recognized tonight. So I'm going to check with Will. I also want to make sure I'm clear. Christy Ross, who is my teammate who helps pull this together in support of the young people, the two of us did a lot of behind the scenes pieces, but our youth members of the Youth Advisory Board did 98% of the work. And Will and Victor, who are two of our Youth Advisory Board members from Granada High School in Livermore and Alameda Science and Technology Institute in Alameda, are two of our tech gurus. I know Will is going to be trying to play the superintendent's video for us. Hopefully that will roll correctly. I know that when I practiced it earlier, I'm going to let you all know, there was a delay when I played it between what she said, but I think that may be a processor issue on my end as well. So, Will, I'm going to go ahead and check in with you. Are we at a point where we can play that video?
Yeah, it's just going to be a little bit delayed.
All right. I am going to screen share with you and let you go ahead and get it started.
Sounds good.
Hello, everyone. I'm Alameda County Superintendent of Schools, L. Karen Monroe, and I want to welcome you here this evening. And though this is a little different for us, this is not how we'd ideally like to get together, it's important to celebrate this important point in time. So, this is a time when we celebrate the public service announcements that are put together by our youth. I'd really like to thank our Youth Advisory Board for judging the entries, and our core learning team, and Scott Gerbert and Christy Ross for really leading this effort. This is so important. It's important to keep this topic in front of adults and youth alike, even in this really challenging time, maybe especially in this really challenging time. We need to continue to understand the importance of telling young people about the dangers of vaping and staying healthy in many, many ways, and this being one critically important one. So I'm excited for you to be honored and to have you see the public service announcements that have been made by our wonderful and creative young people. This is truly youth in action. We know that when young people talk to other young people, they listen. They listen to you. They listen to their peers. And we know these messages actually are very important. And while a fun project and a creative one, the message can save lives. So I appreciate you taking your time. I appreciate your dedication. I hope you're staying safe and well. Have a good time.
Hello, everyone. My name is Meadow, and I'm a junior at Granada High School. I want to welcome all of you to the Alameda County Youth Advisory Board Public Service Award Ceremony, virtual style. We have been hosting this ceremony for years, but this is the first time we are doing it virtually, so we want to thank you all for joining us here tonight. Sahar, would you like to introduce yourself and talk about the contest?
Thanks, Meadow. As Meadow said, my name is Sahar, and I'm a junior at Alameda Science and Technology Institute in the city of Alameda. This year's PSA contest was really competitive, and we are excited to be recognizing the best of the best. Before we get into the awards info, if you are an invited award recipient, please enter your name in the chat feature, first and last name. And if you are a 2B coordinator, please enter your name and school site in the chat feature. Thank you. So are you all ready to find out who the winners are? I know I am. Doing this virtually is actually going to be a surprise for everyone on our Youth Advisory Board team, because as you will see, everyone has a sealed envelope with the information about the winners they are introducing. So without prolonging this any longer, I'm going to turn this over to Victor, a senior from Alameda Science and Technology Institute from Alameda, to announce the third place winner for middle school poster contest. Victor, are you ready?
Thanks, Sahar. I think I've got it. So I'm very excited to announce the first winner of tonight, and it's for the third place middle school posters. So if you're in the top three, you should be very proud, and your posters were very impressive. So just to let everyone know, my name is Victor, and I'm from Alameda Science and Technology Institute. I know it's a mouthful. It's in Alameda, and I'm very proud to be on the Youth Advisory Board. And I hope everyone tonight on our team remembers to say their name and the school district that they represent. And without further ado, I have right here the winner. So drum roll, we have Selena Chambers from Walters Middle School in Fremont. So I'm going to pull that up and I will show you guys the poster. Congratulations, Selena. Now I get to hand it over to Nicole for the second place winner. So, you ready, Nicole?
Yep, I guess it's my turn. Thanks, Victor, and congratulations, Selena. As Victor said, my name is Nicole, and I'm a junior also at Alameda Science and Technology Institute with Victor. Now, I get to announce the second place winner for middle school posters. I don't know how dramatic I can be when opening an envelope via Zoom, but here we go. Drum roll, please. And the second place winner in a middle school poster category is Brian Heppel from Hopkins Junior High. And here is Brian's submission. Congratulations, Brian. So now, I'm going to pass this on to Shreya from Middle School Poster team to announce the first place winner for the Middle School Poster contest. Ready, Shreya? One, two, here you go.
I don't want to risk saying anything, but this virtual ceremony is going way smoother than I thought it would. Good work, Victor and Will, for helping us with the technical stuff tonight. For those of you watching at home, Victor and Will are two members of our Youth Advisory Board, and they're the ones running the technical part of this award ceremony. I know Victor introduced himself earlier, but I wanted you to know the technical stuff he's doing in between announcing awards. So now I get to announce the first place winner of the middle school poster contest. I don't know who it is yet, so let's find out. All right, so I guess I have to say winners, as this is a group submission. So the first place middle school winners are the Green Team from Hopkins Junior High in Fremont. The Green Team members are Natalie Huang, Maryam Nasir, Kirti Gopinath, and Sahana Seth. Like Victor said earlier, this is one of our most competitive areas, so congratulations to the Green Team from Hopkins Junior High and to the other two middle school winners in the poster area. Now I'm going to share the screen with Sabrine, who's going to announce our winners for the high school poster contest.
Thank you, Shreya. It was great to see the winning middle school posters. My name is Sabrina Kubi, and I'm a senior at Newark Memorial High School, and I'll be starting off the high school poster award announcements. So, the high school competition was just as fierce as the middle school competition, and I'm proud to say that I'll be announcing the third place winner. Without any further ado, the third place winner for this category is Clara Merkel from Granada High School in Livermore. Victor, Will, can you show everybody Clara's poster? I want to keep this category going, so I'm actually going to hand it over to Mason, who I think actually goes to Granada. Right, Mason?
That's right, Sabrine. I'm a 10th grader at Granada. I'm glad to see that Granada was well represented in the poster contest. Now I get to announce the second place winner. And the winner is Ricky Titswerk from my school, Granada High, in Livermore. So far, Granada High is two of the top three slots for high school posters. Well, Victor, can you pull up Ricky's poster?
I can't wait to open this envelope and see if Granada made a clean sweep of the high school poster category. So I'm going to open the envelope, and first place in the poster category is, well, it's not from my school, but it was selected by our committee as a first place poster, and it's a team submission from Arroyo High School in San Lorenzo from Team Big Tobacco. It's Andrew Lee, Elvis Anguidanos, Christian Olatero, and Bella Hernandez. Congratulations to the team from Arroyo, and I can totally see how this took first place. Now I'm going to pass it over to Will, one of our tech wizards, making this all happen right now, so he can announce the video contest winners. You ready, Will?
One sec, I think I've got it. Victor, can you get ready with the videos while I'm talking? Awesome, thank you. So far, for the poster part of the contest, both the middle and high school winners have been teams. I wonder if that's going to be true for all the categories. So, as Holly said, I'll now be announcing the third place middle school video submission winners. Let's grab the envelope and find out. And the winners for the third place video submissions are the Bulldogs from Junction Avenue with Amelia Paradise, Sarah Wiley, Elizabeth Cagle, and Riley Kirsch. Victor, can you pull up their video?
Heart disease, and it costs about $2,000 every year. Bring you one, I'll never smoke again.
I got you. Vape pen is safe for all targets to smoking.
That's not true. Vape pens have fun, have at least twice the amount of nicotine in them, which is a harmful addictive substance. Please don't smoke.
Whatever.
Oh, look, flavored air in a bottle. And it's unicorn poop. That looks delicious.
That's not the flavored air in a bottle. It's a vape pen. It will give you major health harm for you.
I will never touch it again. I say no to vaping, and so can you. So let's kick those butts.
Thanks, Victor, and congratulations to Amelia, Sarah, Elizabeth, and Riley. Nice job, girls. Now, we're going to go back over to one of our MCs who started tonight's celebration. Meadow, Victor's going to come back to you now. Are you ready?
I am, Will. Thanks. And congratulations to Team Bulldogs from Junction. Now, I get to announce the second place middle school video winner. And the envelope says... Oh, it looks like we have another team. Second place middle school video goes to Willard Middle School. Congratulations, you guys. I know there's more than five peer educators at Willard, but the ones who submitted their PSA are Ava, Aaron, Noe, May, and Olivia. Let's watch their video now.
I've been addicted to you, and I think you know why. So I tried to decide, it must come to an end. I tried to vow, swear that I would stop, I don't know how. But I suddenly lose control, there's an addiction within my soul. Just one hit and I can taste the addiction. One more hit and I believe in the fiction. Whoa, nicotine, here I go again. My, how can I resist you? Nicotine, now you cough again. My, just how much I need it. Yes, you were acting reckless. Now you're feeling helpless. Why did you ever use it? Nicotine, now you really know. My, you could never let it go.
Okay. If I would have known ahead of time, I would have asked Will or Victor to show everybody's videos from last year. No worries. Great job, Willard. I bet your advisor is really proud of you all. Now, I'm going to hand it off to Harasimar. Harasimar, don't forget to tell everybody what grade you are in and what school you go to. Oh, and also the district.
Thanks, Meadow. Hi, everyone. My name is Harsmar, and I'm a sophomore at Dublin High School. And so far, we've seen that it's been two teams that have taken third and second place in the middle school video category, which means that only first place is left, and it's in this envelope. So let's see what I got. Okay. I can tell you that it is not a team. Without further ado, first place goes to Vincent James from Hopkins Junior High. Congratulations, Vincent. Victor and Will, can we please see Vincent's first place video?
One sec, sorry everyone. Hey man, you wanna try a vape?
Yeah, sure, it looks really cool. It's safe though, right? Yeah, it's just water vapor. I don't know, man. Water vapor doesn't usually have a smell.
Bob's got a good point. Vape contains very little water vapor because it's an aerosol, which, unlike water vapor, contains tiny particles, in this case mainly propylene glycol, the same thing used in antifreeze, along with other carcinogenic and toxic chemicals, which will get into your lungs and other organs when you vape.
What have I ever done to you?
I did kind of want to hang on to my lungs. I'll need them if I'm going to be a football star.
Bob has a very important life choice. He can vape or he can keep his lungs and body healthy and follow his dreams.
On second thought, no thanks.
If Bob can say no to vaping, so can you.
Wow. That was a really, really good video, Vincent. I mean, I think we can all definitely see why the judges scored that so high. So now I'm going to turn it back over to one of our tech gurus, Victor. To announce the third place winners for the high school videos.
Thanks, Harasimar. It's actually been quite fun doing all the behind the scenes stuff while you guys are all on camera. Will, you have the videos, right? So since I said earlier that I go to school in the city of Alameda, I'm not going to reintroduce myself. So I'm going to be announcing the third place high school video. And as a person who records and does videos myself, I know it takes a lot of time and energy to really create these great, great videos. So without further ado, I have the third place high school video here. And in third place, we have Ethan Haynes from Vineyard High.
Sorry about that. Here we go.
Hello, my name's Ethan Haynes. I'm 17 years old. I live in Livermore, California, and this is my story about vaping. When I was a freshman in high school, one of my buddies came up to me and offered me a Juul. And I was like, what is that? And he told me what it was, and I said, cool, let's do it. So I gave it a try. After that, the days after that, more and more people started to get vapes, and I started to get offered more and more. And then that led to me getting my own. And then, so by the time I was a sophomore in high school, I was addicted to nicotine. And I've tried quitting many times. I'm a senior in high school now and still working on it, but it's definitely a difficult one. If I had to give anyone any advice out there, it's much better to just not start instead of starting, wasting your money, ruining your body, creating addiction, having an addiction that you can't really get out of.
And that's my story, and my message to you is don't vape.
Great work, Ethan. Now I'm going to hand it over to Nikita, who I don't think has spoken yet. So, Nikita, please announce your second place high school video winner. And don't forget to say what school you're from. I think you're at Dublin High, right?
You're right, Victor. Good memory. I'm a 10th grader at Dublin High School, and I'm happy to announce the second place winning team tonight. I haven't been keeping track, but it seems about half the winning submissions have been from teams and the other half have been from individuals. Without further ado, the second place winner for the high school video category is Team DNV from Victor's High School, ASTI, Jasmine Chen and Rina Mudakata.
Hi, I'm Rina Mudakata.
I am Jasmine Chen.
We are DNV. We are juniors at Alameda Science and Technology Institute. This is our 2P PSA contest entry. There's a silent killer that lurks the halls, inside, outside, bathroom stalls. It rots our brains, creates thick chains, throws our future down the drain. Vanilla, strawberry, milk, and honey, in this direction, throw your money. For nickel, tin, and lead in your lungs, cancer-causing particles on your tongue, ultrafine chemicals you will breathe for a laurel wreath of death. Smile while it's still funny, the rain will come, though now it's sunny. Once you start, you'll never quit. You'll become a counterfeit of your past self, free from bondage. Why become a slave with this life your parents gave? Deny the crave, and you yourself you will save. Spread the word until it is heard. Become the light in the night. Why vape? Escape.
Great job, Team DNV. Now I'm going to give the screen to Sahar, who I think also goes to ASTI with Victor, and I guess Jasmine and Rina too.
I do go to school with Victor and Jasmine and Rina. Way to represent ASTI, guys. And now I get to announce the first place winner in this category. And the winner is another team. This team is actually from Meadow, Will, and Mason. And I know I'm probably forgetting someone else's school, Granada High. The winning high school team is Zoe Johnson, Grace Blanchard, and Kate Langendorf from Granada High School in Livermore. Let's watch.
Vaping is safe, right? Well, what do you know about vaping? Probably only what you've been exposed to.
In the ads put out, they usually feature bright colors, people with style, appealing flavors, and new sleek technology. You may even see friends, family, or people you look up to use these products like there's nothing to them.
Vaping doesn't seem all that bad, and you might decide to give it a try.
At first, you only vape occasionally, maybe with friends or at parties, but you will start to get used to it and want to vape more often.
Soon after you start, you might start to feel uncomfortable after long periods of time without using your vape.
Now, without it, you will feel agitated and you won't be able to keep your mind away from vaping.
In many cases, once someone is hooked, they will skip out on hanging out with friends and family to avoid situations where they aren't able to vape. In more serious cases, people will take vaping over eating, drinking, and sleeping. On the surface, it's difficult to see the dangers of vaping, but after a while, it can change the way you function as a person.
Your brain chemistry changes and vaping becomes your top priority. You should not let vaping control your life.
Don't believe the fiction. Vaping is an addiction.
That was great. Thank you, Zoe, Grace, and Kate. Now we are heading into our last category, which is high school audio. And I think Bella, Ahalia, and Treyer are going to announce those winners. Bella, you there?
Thanks so much, Zahar. I'm actually really excited because tonight I have two envelopes because I get to announce the only tie for tonight for the high school audio submissions category. So for our first to third place winner, we have Fernando Herrera from San Lorenzo High. Let's give his audio a listen.
Hey bro, check it out. I got a vape pen.
Look man, before you breathe in all those toxic chemicals, let me tell you something. Don't live your life away just for another rich man's gain. You'll end up in the hospital and you'll hate all the pain. How much fun you thought? Don't believe the fiction. It has a bunch of nicotine, the main cause of addiction. That's not the end of it, you'll end up taking harder drugs. When you find out that your vape pen's simply not enough. Acetylpropylene, glycol, nicotine. These chemicals are toxic, inside your lungs won't let you breathe. Don't get me started on the side effects that we know. Wheezing, headaches, fevers, health is going down below. Look man, if you know what's good for you, don't believe the fiction. Vaping is an addiction. Look man, if you know what's good for you, don't vape.
So for our second winners, we have a team. They call themselves the Knockouts, and they're Kate Crawford and Olivia Harrison from ASTI. Let's give their audio a listen.
Hi, my name is Olivia Harrison.
And my name is Kate Crawford.
And we're the Knockouts from Alameda Science and Technology Institute presenting our poem, Fight to Light. The vaping epidemic has flooded our schools, our youth and communities fell victim too.
It's just water vapor, they like to say, but it's aerosol that wastes our lungs away.
The taste of poison has evolved to be sweet. The companies use their devices to cheat us out of our health, our breath, our lives, and the youth can't help but believe their lies.
In attempts to quit and not fall to cigarettes, we've gone and placed our lives in threat of false truths that tell us vaping is safer, but we have grown addicted to craving the flavor.
The flavor of propylene glycol antifreeze.
Acrolein used to kill weeds.
Heavy metals like nickel, tin, and lead.
From these dangers, teens are misled.
The billowing smoke blows through the halls, infiltrating our brains, lungs, body, and all.
It is our duty to bring these truths to light. Against vaping companies, we initiate the fight.
I love that I got to announce our only tie. That was really cool. So now I'm going to pass this over to Ahalia, who's going to announce the second place winners for the high school audio submission.
Thanks, Bella. Now I get to announce a second place audio winner, but I only have one envelope, so unless it's a team, I only get to announce one winner. So in my envelope, it says that the winner is Nina Mutalat from Amador Valley High in Pleasanton. That's our first winner from Pleasanton this year. Let's hear Nina's audio clip.
My name is Nina Mutalat. I'm from Amador Valley High School, and this is We Will Find the Truth. There's so much we teens have to fight for.
We have to scream to be heard.
As everyone around us tells us what to do and who to be, now there's a new cause we have to fight for. We can't stand by while strawberry smoke singes our peers' throats, while it takes away our voices, while vaping becomes normal. We are the generation of information. With technology at the tips of our fingers, we won't be fooled by the flavors they say aren't meant to get kids hooked. We won't blindly follow those who say it's safe. We know better than to believe that vaping isn't addictive. We will not believe the lies. We will fight for our health. We will find the truth.
Great job, Nina. And now for the last award of the night, I'm going to hand it back to Shreya to announce the first place winner or winner.
Thank you, Ahalia. And yes, I get to announce the last PSA winner of tonight. And even though I'm bummed out with the fact that we didn't get to do this in person, I think it's gone pretty well. So for first place in the high school audio, the winner is, it's a team. From ASTI in Alameda, it's the Vaping Rebels, Trista Perlan, Katie Tong, and Alex Wu. Victor, since they are from your school, can you please play their audio clip?
Hi, my name is Trista Perlan, and my teammates are Kaylee Tong and Alex Wu. We are from Alameda Science and Technology Institute, and the title of our PSA is Drugs Don't Do Favors. 1 joule, 2 joules, red juice, blue juice. Say, what a lot of nicotine there is. Yes, some might malfunction and some might explode. Dangers cannot be reversed. This is your life. You can't rehearse. Not conventional, still intentional. Don't trust the fiction, don't trust the lies. E-cigs are equally harmful in disguise. Growth is stunted, lungs grunted. Mood swings galore, sad happy depression, and more. Did you ever try the juice? From the cellars to our youth. They have green tea, cola, melon madness too. Third-party handlers don't give a baloney. FDA regulations? Phony. The youth fall victim to shameless advertising. 8,000 fun flavors make e-cigs more appetizing. 7,000 ingredients, including copper, tin, and lead. Let's not end up dead. Don't fall for these tricks. You know better than this. Better beat the fiction, because vaping is the addiction.
Great job, Vaping Rebels. So before I hand it back over to Sahar and Meadow to close out tonight's awards ceremony, I want to personally congratulate all the winners from all the categories. And I also want to once again thank Will and Victor for all the behind-the-scenes production tonight. So, Sahar and Meadow, ready to wrap up the ceremony and celebration?
Thanks, Shreya, and congratulations to all the PSA award winners tonight. Before we wrap up tonight's event, would any of the YAB members like to add anything else?
Hey, Meadow, it looks like Sahar's having some technical difficulties right now, so you're just going to have to wrap up the ending. Continue on with what you were going to say.
I see that Matt, Grace, and Dia all have something they want to add. Let's go with Matt first. Matt?
First, a special shout out to all the winners from Fremont. I'm going to talk with some people at the Fremont School District office and make sure the district knows who won and try to get you on a school board agenda. Second, I just wanted to encourage my fellow YAB members to do the same and make sure the school districts know who won. Again, congrats to everyone.
Thanks, Matt. Okay, Grace, what did you want to add now?
Well, Matt actually stole part of what I wanted to say, but I did want to let the winners know that the Youth Advisory Board will be contacting your schools and your districts to let them know that you won. I also wanted to announce that applications for next year's board are officially open. So if anyone here is interested tonight and you're in grades 8 through 11th, you should totally join. I actually think that 3 or 4 of our YAB members won the previous PSA contests. That's all I had to add.
Thanks, Grace. I think you're right. I know that Jenny won for a song a few years ago that she wrote. Okay, and Dia, what would you like to add?
2 quick things. First of all, I want to thank Will and Victor for making the technology work tonight and for doing all the fun behind-the-scenes tech stuff. Secondly, I want to make sure that the winners know how you're going to get your prizes and certificates. I believe that Christy and Scott from the County Office of Education will be contacting the winners and getting you your prizes and certificates after the shelter in place has ended, because they aren't allowed to mail the gift cards. Congrats, everybody!
Thank you for everybody that was joining us, PSA winners, 2P coordinators, and anybody else here. This was an amazing event, and as Grace mentioned, this event was sponsored by the Alameda County Office of Youth Advisory Board, and anyone who is 8th grade to 11th grade right now should consider applying to be a YAB for next year and be a part of planning and running this contest for next year. Good night, everybody!
Okay, Scott, I think we're ready to cut the video now. Thank you to everyone who showed up tonight.